This one is a true story. It really happened to me. So, a couple of weeks ago, I was fast asleep, and then I woke up in the middle of the night because I thought I heard a knock at my window, which is strange. So I got up and had a look, but I couldn't see anything. So I figured I must have just dreamt it. So I went back to sleep, and then I guess a little bit later, I heard the knocking again. So I got up, but I realized it wasn't coming from my window. It was coming from that mirror. I'm kidding. You should have seen your face. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Alright, alright. Let's get into it. So, snacks or movie selection? What should we do first? Snacks. Yeah, I figure. So, my mom is so cute. She got everything for us. Yeah, she spoils me. So, I've got a whole bucket of candy corn. And look, it is homemade. 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 Candy corn. Candy corn. You can have your own bucket if you want. That's so much of it. How cute. And oh, I don't mean candy corn. It's like caramel corn. Sorry. They didn't have any candy corn in store. And yeah, this is homemade. Yeah, this is fresh.
Just like everyone.
or whatever, and like monsters just look like people with like Halloween masks on. But I love it nonetheless. But basically there's three kids. Their grandmother, she's a witch from Halloween Town. But their mom doesn't want them to know. She tries to hide it from them. But Marnie, the oldest, she finds out that, because she's 13, that if she doesn't get her witch training on Halloween, she will lose her powers forever. So she secretly travels back to Halloween Town with her grandmother, but she doesn't know until it's too late and they're in Halloween Town and all her siblings come. But there's a dark and evil force sweeping over Halloween Town, and it's up to the Cromwell kids, the Cromwells, to save the day. But in some ways it kind of reminds me a little bit of Harry Potter in terms of how there's the different worlds. Like there's, I guess, normal America, and then there's Halloween Town, and how there's like a history to Halloween Town, and there's certain rules and things like that. But it's, yeah, it's definitely a lot more low budget. I mean, their brooms, oof, they're a little interesting. But yeah, it's super cute. And the grandma, she has a microwave, and there's three buttons on it: bubble, doil, and trouble. And so when she goes and microwaves something, she hits bubble, bubble, doil, and trouble in love. So that's Grandma Agatha, or Aggie as she goes by. And I'll show you the next one, which is, gives me kind of similar vibes. Alright, now this one is Double, Double, Toil and Trouble, and it's got the Olsen twins in it. Mary Kate and Ashley, my faves. And look, it's even got the little AOL keyword thing. Do you remember that? Oh my gosh, it's so cute. So this one also came out in 1993, and it's another like cute grandma movie. And so basically their grandma is trapped by an evil curse by her evil twin sister called Agatha. So I guess that was a popular like grandma name back in the day. But I don't know, it's super adorable. Like, it's got the Olsen twins and magic and grandmas. Like, I love me some quaint Halloween films like this. And did you know that the title Double Double, Doyle and Trouble, it's actually Shakespearean? Yes, it's from Macbeth. Double, double, doil and trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble. It's from Act 4, Scene 1, to be specific. Alright, now I'll show you some other options. Technical achievement. Amazing. special effects, but all the makeup that they wear when they, the witches wear, all the prosthetics and everything, is absolutely terrifying. So this one, it came out in 1990. And actually, I just saw they're actually making a new version in 2021. But it's been, I guess, indefinitely delayed due to, you know, he who shall not be named. Or maybe it's a she. But we've got this one, and I mean, it is such a gem, like the parts that I've seen of it. But the story goes, there's a young boy and his grandma, and he's told stories by his grandma about witches and to avoid certain old ladies that he thinks might be a witch, because you know they like eat children and all that good stuff. Anyway, so they go on a holiday to a seaside resort. Out that when they've booked their stay is at the same time that the annual witches convention is being held at that very hotel. Terrifying, like hundreds of witches in one hotel. Oh my gosh. But it's great, and it's got Angelica Houston in it as well, so you know it's gonna be great. Okay, you must like musicals.